Young Women is an organization that was created by young women for young women. And the main aim is to create a new generation of young women leaders who are able to be inspired and who are ready to take the lead on issues in their communities like we're doing right now.
So what we do is to make sure that the women are inspired, and as well as they have to achieve their individual and as well as their collective interests when it comes to mentorship and as well as raising awareness and campaigning. So what we do is to inspire young people to create a generation of young, enlightened young women.
I think Young Women, we believe in harnessing the power of youth, leveraging the power of youth and youth voices in the campaign to end FGM. Yes, it has been happening for a long time, for over 3 decades now, but we believe there needs to be a certain shift in the way we do things, and this is why we're trying to look at how we can mainstream youth voices in the campaign. And since the last FGM, YFGM, that's the National Youth Forum on FGM, the first one we had last year, we were able to get a lot of attention on FGM. There's a lot more media coverage. There's a lot more conversations happening around the topic.
The National Youth Forum and FGM is a forum where young people come together and discuss on the overview about what they do in their different regions and also the way forward. So coming together, we all engage in dialogue in terms of the work we've been doing in different regions and youth organizations.
We believe that FGMC is a national issue. And knowing the fact that Gambia is a youthful population, we tend to focus more of our national agenda, and therefore we decided that it's important we bring about every other young person across the country, and thus is the reason why we invited people from all the regions in the Gambia.
The entire country is represented through a process, and all this process are young people come from across the country, and we are all exposed to the danger of FGM. And we also discuss about resolution and things that we think if we put forward, we will be able to convince our stakeholders, our authorities at various regions to at least stop the impact of FGM at our level.
So bringing these youths together, they will not be only be able to know the dangers, know the effects or health implications of FGM, but they will also be able to learn from each other as to why FGM is practiced in various communities in the Gambia, because people do it for different reasons. So as a result, people coming together and joining heads together will be able to learn more, and after that go back into their communities to be able to advocate or implement activities that will create awareness amongst other people that we are not really fortunate enough to come to this forum.
You know, this has created us to interact amongst ourselves, and this have helped us to learn from one another's culture, because as we settle in our various regions, our cultures differs. So, you know, this have really given us that opportunity to integrate some of, you know, those cultural barriers that we have as regions.
We have also had several plenary discussions where the participants were able to view or voice out some of the things that they feel is are their challenges rather at their regional levels, and then what do they think are the way forward and how can they better make changes into their communities. They came up with strategic plans that they think they need to work on, and hopefully when we get funding we'll be able to implement some of these activities, especially going into their regions and various districts and have the message disseminated.
Information is very crucial with regards to advocacy work, and we have organized a series of trainings for advocates, and we believe that it's important that they have the relevant and the prerequisite knowledge that they need in order to go about their advocacy, because sometimes it is very difficult, and we know that issues of FGM is a very deep-rooted culture in the Gambia, and therefore advocates need to get the right and correct information, and also know the approach that they're going to use in talking to people.
We're dealing with the Gambian context. People are very
have very strong beliefs in traditions and in religion, and FGM is linked to these two things particularly. So when you understand this, it also guides you in what messages you are taking to what community and at what level it's going to create an impact for you.
The relevance of the sessions on advocacy and campaigning and the impact they would have at the grassroots level for us, it's very important because we believe we need to understand the materials we're going into the communities with. We need to understand the information we're taking, but of course the strategies also we're going to employ to make sure people actually pay attention to the messages we're bringing and that they're able to act based on the messages that we have.
Advocacy is very important as far as the work that we do is concerned, because of we should be able to know the right terminologies to use. We should, so that we, when we go into communities, we don't offend them. We should be able to know what platforms to use when we want to push our agenda and make people, convince them, raise more awareness for people to be able to change their perceptions. Both the Children's Act and the Women's Act protect women from women and children from violence. They protect women and children from harmful traditional practices, especially those that affect their health. They protect women to be able to access reproductive health services, as well as torture, inhuman and degrading treatment. So relying on these provisions, of course, we would be able to prosecute the practice of FGM. But again, we can prosecute people under these provisions that I have talked about. Discrimination, right to life, the right to health, the freedom from inhuman and degrading treatment. We can also prosecute them on the right to dignity as well. These are all things that we can prosecute people on.
If you have to tell people that FGM is a human rights violation, you should be able to teach them, because you can't just say that it's a human rights violation when you don't have concrete reasons. The reason why we feel that law is very important in everything that we do, it's like a prerequisite for everything that you do. And if you have a law to back up your claims with, you have a more opportunity to be able to come out successfully. We've also been able to interact with them, especially the next day, about Islam and FGM, where we brought in an Islamic scholar to discourse with them and talk to them, because we're not learned in the Quran. Of course, we have to be very sure and be very careful of some of the things that we said. And it is on this basis that we decided to call in an expert in that area in Islam to be able to tell them about FGM and Islam. So finally, we are also able to involve health specialists, someone that does this work, people that have undergone FGM, some of the things that have happened to them, the after effects of them. He's one of the people that have direct contacts with these victims of female genital mutilation.
Scientifically, we have found some benefit for male circumcision, but there has been no benefit found with female genital mutilation at all. In fact, it's only a harmful practice.
The Dr. Jess presentation was a great impact on me, because most of the time I get information, just mere information, that FGM do this, do that, but I never see the real pictures or the real face of FGM. Today is the first day that Dr. Ja saw the pictures that are locally relevant.
Female genital mutilation is a problem that is very complicated and shrouded with lots of mysticism, with social pressures, tradition, and therefore anybody who wants to advocate against female genital mutilation must be equipped with the factual knowledge of female genital mutilation, with the scientific knowledge about female genital mutilation, so that when they talk to people, they can tell them why it is a bad practice and why we should no longer be engaged in female genital mutilation. Therefore, it is very, very important for advocates to learn.
Gambia has gone really far in terms of FGM advocacy because we all know that organizations have been advocating against FGM for the past 3 decades or over 3 decades, organizations like Gamco Tribe and more. But then there's a lot more work to do, as we all know. The ban, the announcement, it doesn't mean our job has gone easier. It means we have a lot more work to do in terms of advocacy in the Gambia.
So I think it's important that we not only just want to share the information or trying to convince people, but it's also important to listen to people and know why they are still holding on to the practice, despite all the numerous activities that have been done, despite all the campaign that has been going on for over 3 decades now. So that is something that they really, really need to watch out for.
When it comes to FGM, it doesn't only stop here. Or let's say when it comes to campaigning and as well as advocacy, it doesn't just have to stop in the four corners of the world right now and as well as the participant. It has to sink down. And to us, how do we do that? We make sure that we have what we call monitoring and evaluation. And we already have a team in which they'll make sure that these are things that we'll have. Shortly, we'll have a declaration and as well as the view of all the participants. And these are things that we'll do to pass as well as to pass a bill and have a law.
So if you know the dangers of FGM and you're also aware that it's not a religious obligation, I'm sure you'll be in a better position to shape the future for yourselves and also the future of your children. I've been rightly informed that at the end of this workshop, a strategy will be developed. And that strategy I would like you to share with UNFPA, because we will continue to support the implementation of the strategy. We are working with Think Young Women, Girls Agenda, Safe Hands for Girls, and National Youth Council, simply because these are all young people. And at UNFPA today, the UN agenda of the youth is very, very important to us.
The idea is that we are the people who actually have the chance to stop the practice in a generation. So if each and every one of us young people decides this is going to stop at my level, I'm going to stop the practice in my family, then we're certain that it will stop at this generation. So we feel it is important to get young people involved in the campaigns, in all of the efforts that are happening, using tools like social media, of course, it's very important, grassroots advocacy, getting into the communities, talking to our peers. So it's important that we target young people in the work that we are doing to get the messages to them to ensure that this practice is broken in a generation.
We're going to continually work with youth organizations that have interest in the fight against FGM. We've done it with Safe Hands for Girls. Since last year, we have been implementing activities together with them. We work closely with the Girls Agenda. So it is not only limited to this, because we also work with the National Youth Council, and we're calling on more youth organizations that are interested in working in the fight against FGM to come closely, to come to us, or we can go to them. If they're interested, they could just reach out and we would make this partnership bigger. For the donors, where our doors are always open, we have series of activities on our work plan that if we get funding for it, we would implement it. There are those that we don't even wait for funding. We implement it at our own level. We conduct trainings for our members. We have a membership-based organization, so we have those trainings for our members. So we're just calling on everyone that is interested in this fight to come, and then we would join hands together and partner with you at any point in time, and then we implement our activities together.
Our sincere thanks and appreciation goes out to UNFPA. They have been there for Think Young Women in almost all of our activities on FGMC in the Gambia. And we want to thank them sincerely and appreciate the efforts that they've been putting on, both technical and financial support that they have been giving us.
We at UNFPA are working closely with Think Young Women because we have trust and confidence in Think Young Women.
Again, we also want to thank Safe Hands for Girls for partnering with Think Young Women, the National Youth Council. They have been really there with us, and then we really appreciate their efforts.